Almost 2 years ago, I did a video on XFCE's Trials and Tribulations with Wayland. Honestly, at the time, they basically weren't anywhere near supporting Wayland. Yes, they were working on it, but a lot of people didn't really think it was ever going to happen, and XFCE is a fairly small project anyway, and a lot of things to port, so it wasn't really looking great at the time. Now, at that time, we were looking at the release of 4.18, and there was work being done. The main work was a single developer, Adlo, working on a project called XF Way. This was a port of XFWM over to Wayland with the WLroots library, and it wasn't in anywhere near of a state to ship. But there was something there that was functional. Now, this WLroots base port was an alternative to another version being worked on, that being the lib Western port. Now, Western is technically the reference implementation of Wayland. Nowadays, though, it doesn't really do a good job at that. It's more like the embedded implementation of Wayland, because nowadays the amount of protocols that Western actually implements is a fraction of the protocol extensions that are actually in use. I would argue that WLroots is a much better reference implementation, with the Sway compositor being a reference implementation of WLroots. Now, at the time, all of this work was relatively new, both the Western version and the WLroots version. The WLroots version was starting to see support for very important protocols like WLR foreign top level, which is what you use for taskbars, docs, and things like that, and the dev at the time felt like it was basically at feature parity with the Western-based approach. But this is a very important part of porting a desktop environment over to Wayland. The window manager and compositor component is a very small part of actually doing that port. It is a very important part, but without dealing with all of the other tooling, you haven't really done that port, and XFCE, like GNOME, like KDE, like any other desktop environment, has a bunch of additional tooling that you want to make sure also works under Wayland. A lot of things probably would be fine just running under XWayland. If we're dealing with like a text editor or a terminal, things like that, yes, you would want them to be ported over to Wayland, but they're going to work exactly the same way running through XWayland. Mostly exactly the same way. There's a couple of issues when it comes to dealing with resizing and other little edge case things, but to the average user, it's gonna look pretty much the same. But when we're dealing with things like docs and launches, you want to make sure they're actually using the correct Wayland protocols. But the very worst one is the lock screen. If you do not port this and you try to run it through XWayland, you will not have a functional lock screen. A lock screen either needs to rely on the protocol for doing lock screens under Wayland, or it needs to be built directly into the desktop. If you don't do one of these approaches, you don't have a lock screen, you just have an application that can very easily be bypassed. Now, 2 years might not feel that long, and I know that feeling. I have no idea where this year went, I have no idea where the previous year went, time is going way too quickly. But over this time, you have a lot of chances to fix up issues, to make things better, and make the Wayland port actually come along. And the Wayland roadmap today looks much, much better than it did 2 years ago. Most of this is yes, with the exception of one thing, one very important thing, and we'll get to that in just a bit. All of this stuff down here, with the exception of a couple of things, are yes. Going down here, yes, bunch more yeses. Most things now say yes. And most things also don't have additional notes of things that like might still be kind of an issue. Yes, it is still very far from ready, but it's come a very long way. And just the other day, after almost 2 years of work, we are happy to announce the release of XFCE 4.20. But that part isn't what I really care about. The major focus during this development cycle was the preparation of the codebase to be ready for Wayland, so that we meanwhile have experimental Wayland support for most components. And this is the very key part. It is not everything yet, it is not fully ready, but there is experimental support that you can go and mess around with if that's the kind of thing you like to do. but let's go and check the 4.22, which has a lot more details. This was written by Alexander Schwinn, otherwise known as Alex Cons, and thankfully, the Wayland part is right at the top. Please, if you have a Wayland support you're working on for a project, put it right here. It makes my life a lot easier. It means I don't have to scroll as much. Please be aware that the Wayland support in XFCE 4.20 is experimental. It is recommended for advanced users only, as you may encounter bugs and experience incomplete functionality. Proceed with caution. As I mentioned during my cosmic stuff, this is alpha, this is experimental. Just don't expect it to be a rock solid experience. If you go into it knowing what you're doing, you'll be fine. Just know what you're doing. Much like the Wayland experience would have been on GNOME and KDE back in, say, 2014. They were not ready to daily drive for most people, and that's why the projects were definitely not defaulting to using Wayland. There were some distros that were, but that's a whole different story. Now, the X part of XFCE isn't just going to stop making sense anytime soon. There is going to be support long into the future for both Wayland windowing and X11 windowing. The idea is for Wayland to not go and cannibalize the X11 side. If there comes a point where X11 is just no longer being shipped on any mainstream distro, and they just don't feel like it needs to be there anymore, I don't know if they're going to drop it or they're just going to stop maintaining it, but both are going to be there as a separate way to run things. And doing this early is a very good thing, because unlike something like GNOME and KDE, which have pretty much perfectly working Wayland sides, yes, there are still issues that need to be addressed, but most of those are general Wayland issues, not specific to those desktops, and then newer desktops like Cosmic, which just don't have X11 support just to begin with, XFCE is still a very long way from even remotely considering the question of whether they should drop X11 or not. But it is going to have to happen eventually, and making sure that can be done cleanly then is better than just waiting. This major effort was achieved by abstracting away any X11/Wayland windowing specific calls and making use of Wayland/WLroots protocols. A whole new XFCE library, libxfce for windowing, was introduced during that process. XWayland will not be required to run any of the ported XFCE components. I would hope that the ported components do not need XWayland, because otherwise they would not have been ported. Now, I'm not 100% certain, but I believe I have talked about this library in a separate video. If I recall correctly, brought this up because there were people who misunderstood what was being said here and made it out like XFCE couldn't be ported to Wayland or was never going to be ported to Wayland because they read the description and decided to interpret it in a completely incorrect way. Now, remember how I mentioned there was one very important component that is not yet supported over on the Wayland side, that being XF4WM. That is the window manager component, and that is also going to be the compositor. That is the core of the Wayland experience. If you're thinking of the X11 world, this basically serves the role of Xorg. So it's very, very important. As such, XFCE does not yet feature a compositor which supports Wayland. However, do not be concerned, because there are other desktops in this exact same position. Just use an existing compositor in its place. If you want to run XFCE in Wayland, LabWC and Wayfire will give you the best results. A detailed instruction can be found right here. Please be aware that Wayland support is still experimental. Once again, experimental on experimental. Using these different compositors is extra experimental. Down the bottom here, you'll find everything you need to know. This bit right here is very, 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 very out of date. The NVIDIA GPU driver very much does support Wayland, and it's actually good support right now, so can somebody go and remove that? Thanks, that would be nice. Besides that though, a WLroots compositor is almost a prerequisite for most core components, as well as panel plugins and some apps, at least to ensure that all features ported to Wayland are available. The default compositor is LabWC, but Wayfire is another WLroots compositor on which tests have generally been carried out. if both of these work fine, you're pretty much gonna be good on anything double your roots based. So if you want a tiling experience, something like Sway will work or River, but this is the more XFCE-like experience. Yes, tiling is cool, but that's not generally what you expect to get if you're using XFCE. If you run start XFCE --Wayland from a TTY, that will launch the XFCE 4 session from LabWC. Now, from the Wayfire side, there is an option to do that. Start XFCE 4 --Wayland Wayfire, but you also need to add this into your configuration as well to make sure the XFCE session actually gets auto-started. With that being said, there's probably no reason why others wouldn't work as well if that's what you want to use instead. Keep in mind though, because everything here is experimental, you're going to have very little support, and you're going to have even less support if you go and use a compositor that they don't list as directly technically being supported. Now, there's some desktops we've seen where this is the permanent plan they use, and they're going to use another compositor rather than making their own. That is not the case for XFCE. Plans are underway to add Wayland support to XFWM4 while preserving its X11 functionality. However, such a restructurization will be a major effort, and we cannot tell you yet when/if it will be done. So please don't hold your breath waiting for it. Just having something there, building it so you can go and use other compositors, that's better than nothing, and it is going to get you most of the way there. Now, in its current state, there are some areas of concern. For few components and multiple features, it was not possible to port them to Wayland, partially because there are no standardized Wayland protocols available yet to provide the required services. Workspace support is missing. Now, every desktop does have support for workspaces, but they all do it in a slightly different way. Now, very happily for my side, EXT Workspace Protocol was just merged, and I'm going to do a separate video on this because I've talked about needing something like this for a very long time. I didn't realize there was something in the works. SysTray icons will be missing for multiple applications. For the XFCE 4 settings, the keyboard and mouse settings so far are internal to the Wayland compositor, and as such, the according XFCE dialogues won't be available on Wayland yet. If they wanted to do this, they would need to build custom backends for each of the different compositors they are supporting, because actually you probably could get away with most of it being done just generically for WRoots, but if you wanted to support something like Myr, you would need to do that, and some of the WRoots implementations might do things a little bit differently, so there's no guarantee that things are going to work the exact same way. It's kind of just a big mess not having your own internal compositor. Power-related keyboard handling, brightness keys, suspend, etc. is internal to the Wayland compositor, and as such cannot be supported yet by XFCE components. This is kind of partially true. So WRoots does have a protocol called WLR Gamma Control Unstable. This can be used for brightness and redshifting and things like that, and at least for lock screens, there is the layer shell protocol. Now, suspending might be a bit more annoying, but because you're just trying to support things based on WRoots, there's probably some generic way you can do it. And Wayland does not specify a native protocol for taking screenshots. Again, technically not correct. So on WRoots, there is the screen copy protocol for the entire screen. There is another protocol for doing individual windows, but when we're dealing with screenshotting on Wayland, this is done the same way as screen capture with a portal-based approach. And WRoots doesn't have a perfect portal, but it's good enough for at least doing that. However, whether it's that solution or a protocol-based solution, it is going to require actually porting the tool over, and that work hasn't been done yet. And speaking of porting, there is one thing the desktop is not abandoning that a lot of others already have. XFCE 4 screensaver, the porting to Wayland has been completed, but not merged, as it requires the experimental libwl embed library. Most desktops have completely given up on the idea of a screensaver. I don't really think they're that important, and I think it's fine to do so. But if you actually care about them, XFCE might be one of the last ones that actually have support on Wayland. And you know what? If nothing else, I think that is really cool. So the Wayland support still has quite a bit to go. It's definitely not done yet, it's definitely not stable, and it's definitely experimental. But progress is being made, and maybe by the next major release, things are going to be ready. We'll have to wait and see. Until then though, I will let you go about your day. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I completely forgot my outro for a second there.